What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing Nessus Essentials within Kali. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about installing Nessus within Kali. I'm getting into the security, cybersecurity world, and using this utility within your 9-to-5 or your lab is great because it will actually allow you to scan your virtual machines or physical servers to make sure everything is kosher before you put it into production. So if you have any critical security issues, you got to patch it up, because if not, you know, that's not a good thing, right? So first thing that we need to do is head over into the Nessus website and, you know, click on download. It's going to want you to register to get an activation code. So just fill out your name, fill out your last name, give it a legit email and your organization. And if you want to get updates, just check that off and just click on get started. Now, once you fill all that information out and you get started, you get this. It's not going to automatically give you the activation code and download it for you. So you got to give it some time and check your email. Now, for me, I checked my email, and this is the email that you're going to get. And, you know, it gives you the activation code and it gives you a nice big button that says download Nessus. So just click on that within your email. And also copy and paste your activation code, because you're going to be needing that to activate your, your application. So once you click on that, it's going to redirect you here. We're going to definitely just click on the first one, which is right here. So click on view downloads, and it's going to load this page up. Now, because I'm installing everything within Kali, I am able to just pick Linux Ubuntu. And this is the current version that I downloaded. So I'm just going to click on the download button. And once you click on that, you're going to get the following dialog box, your license agreement. So just click on agree. Once you agree, depending on your browser, I am using Firefox within Kali. So it is going to download it and it's going to give you a nice little window right here. It's already downloaded. It's really small. So on my Kali desktop, I am going to open up the terminal. And within the terminal, I am going to do the following command, cd downloads, because we are going to change the directory to go into downloads. Within downloads, I'm going to run the following command, and it's going to call out the Nessus package. Okay, we're going to use the command of dpkg with a switch of I, and you're going to call out the Nessus package. So once you hit enter, it's going to start reading the database. It's going to compile it. It's going to do its thing. This process takes a bit, but eventually, once everything is done, it's going to start installing itself. Once the installation is completed, the way that you know it is done is that it gives you this information right here. Boom. It actually gives you the HTTPS address, which is the local server. And it actually is using port 8834. Well, you don't want to open up the browser automatically, but what you really need to do, and for the instructions that I found on their website, is once the installation is completed, before even heading to the browser to continue the configuration, we need to actually do the following. Run a systemctl command start and the Nessus services, because you want that to start automatically if the machine gets restarted. Once you hit enter, it's done. It's the services already registered to automatically start up. Now open up your browser. I opened up my browser within Kali. It is Firefox. We're going to type in the URL, which is the following, which is the name of the computer with the port of 8834. So hit enter. It's going to give you this, which is okay. Click on advance. We do accept the risks and conditions. So just click on this button to continue, and it's going to load this up. We're not offline, but if you are offline, just make sure you check this off right here. We're going to click on continue. Pick your option. I'm going to pick register for the Nessus Essentials. So select that. We're going to click on continue. Fill out your name, fill out your last name, your email. That is up to you if you want to do that, but you are able to skip it. I think I just clicked on skip, and it's going to want you to enter your activation code. So Like I told you before, copy and paste that activation code that you got within your email, paste it in here. Once you paste it in here, just basically click on continue. Once you click on continue, it's going to take you here. This is your license information. Click continue again. Enter a username and password. This is going to be the account that allows you to log into the portal to do your scanning. So once you enter your username and a password, just click on submit. Once you get that information, make sure you jot that down, remember it. And it's going to start downloading the plugins and it's going to start initializing and it's going to log you into the plugin. Now, on the upper right hand side, you should see a notice that the plugins are compiling. Give it enough time, it should change to this right here, this little circle. It's going to go circle around in circles and it's going to be compiling the plugins. Now, once everything is completed, it should take you to this page here. And eventually, if I recall, you should get a wizard. Now, it's going to welcome you and it's going to want you to enter your targets. Now, for my target, I wanted to do an entire subnet. And this is the subnet that I provided. I clicked on submit. It started scanning and it saw everything within my network. Now, I'm only going to select two of them. With the license that you get, you have 14 hosts, and actually 16 hosts that you're able to monitor and scan, which is awesome. 16 is not that bad. You are able to purchase to increase that, but 16 for me, for my small lab, was awesome. So I actually selected 134 and 136. Those are the two services that I wanted to scan to make sure everything is legit with them. I'm going to click on run scan. Once I do that, that window's gonna disappear and eventually, just give it some time, you're going to see that both hosts that you selected is going to have information. Now, everything is in blue. So the blue right here indicates it is info. At the moment, I don't have anything critical or high, but again, give it some time for the scan to go and do its thing on those hosts that you selected. Now, 134, 136 are the following within my environment. 134 is my domain controller, and the other machine was my 136, which is a Windows 11 machine, okay? PC and a server. That's what I wanted to scan. Now, eventually, everything should stop with the scanning, and I did get some critical problems within my domain controller. You are able to select one of these hosts. For this video, I actually selected my 134, which was my domain controller, and it gives you a nice view of everything that was picked up during the scan. A lot of information, a lot of mixed informational stuff that you are able to go over. You're able to sort everything out and look at what was critical. For me, the critical was the SSL medium strength cipher suite supported. So when you double click on that, it gives you a nice description of what it is and you're able to do a little bit more research to fix it and patch it within that server. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.